Bibliophiles of the internet, my name is Avery, and today I'm here to bring you another installment of the A to Z of Queer Lit. So the last time I did this challenge of sorts was in June of 2019, so I figured it was about time for another update. This video challenge was created by George Lester, the now published author of Boy Queen, and I also saw that Kathy recently did her 7th and 8th installments of the A to Z of Queer Lit, which inspired me to make this video, so both of their videos will be included downstairs and you should definitely check them out. In case you don't know, the idea behind this video is that you name one queer book for every letter of the alphabet, and the letter has to appear either in the title or in the author's name. So I thought I would make it even more fun by exclusively using 2020 releases. As always, this list is neither extensive nor exhaustive, but if you're looking for a little roundup of queer books released in 2020, this is it. And unless otherwise stated, all of these books are own voices. So for the letter A, I chose Anna on the Edge by AJ Sass. It's a middle grade story about a non-binary ice skater named Anna who's wanting to experiment with her gender and skating performance when she meets another young skater who is openly trans. B is for All Boys Aren't Blue by George M. Johnson. It's a YA memoir detailing George's experience growing up as a queer black kid and having to navigate toxic masculinity, racialization, and displacement, as well as their journey growing into a journalist and activist. C is for, you guessed it, Cemetery Boys by Aiden Thomas. It's a YA paranormal romance about a trans Latinx brujo named Yadriel trying to prove his magical abilities to his deeply traditional family and how he maybe falls in love with a dumbass ghost he summoned by accident. D is for The Sound of Stars by Alechia Dow. It's an incredibly soft YA contemporary sci-fi about a young black demisexual teen librarian named Ellie who is defying the tyrannical alien race that has taken over Earth by continuing to loan out books, which are forbidden. And everything changes when her underground library is discovered by one of those aliens. E is for Elatsoe by Darcie Little Badger. It's a contemporary fantasy about Elatsoe, who is Lipan Apache and asexual and has the ability to raise the spirits of animals. When her cousin is killed in a suspicious accident, it's up to her and her friends to uncover the truth and seek out justice. F is for Felix Ever After by Kacen Callender. After Felix Love, a young black trans artist, was recently outed at his school, someone begins sending him anonymous transphobic messages online, and Felix thinks he knows who's behind it, so he decides to catfish his potential suspect, landing him in a strange quasi-love triangle he did not expect. G is for The Gravity of Us by Phil Stamper. It's a YA contemporary story about aspiring journalist and social media star Cal, whose life is turned upside down when his dad is accepted to be part of NASA's first ever mission to Mars. H is for Meet Cute Club by Jack Harbon. It's an adult romance about Jordan, who runs a romance book club, and when the new bookseller at his local indie sees Jordan checking out a towering stack of historical romances, he takes an immediate and definite interest. I is for I'll Be the One by Lyla Lee. This YA contemporary has two bisexual main characters. It stars a young aspiring K-pop idol named Sky, who's always been told that she's too fat to be successful, but she's aiming to silence her haters for good by entering herself in an internationally televised competition and finally taking her shots. J is for Finding Joy by Adriana Herrera. When Dominican-American Desta Joy Walker finally makes the journey to his family's homeland of Ethiopia, he finds himself working with a handsome and charming co-worker named Elias, and now he's having to navigate a potential romance while reconnecting with his family's past. K is for Darius the Great Deserves Better by Adib Khorram. After coming back home from Iran, Darius thought his life was on the upswing now that he's on the varsity soccer team, has an internship at a local tea shop, and his first ever boyfriend, but when the dynamic of his friend group starts shifting, he realizes that his life might still get even more complicated than he thinks. L is for Love After the End, edited by Joshua Whitehead. It's an anthology of speculative fiction and SFF written by Indigenous authors, and it uses indigiqueer futurism as a way to combat colonialism and make space for Indigenous imagination and existence. M is for Miss Meteor by A.M. McLemore and Taylor K. Mejia. It's a dual POV story with a touch of magical realism about two very different Latinx girls. One is a butch pansexual loner and the other is a fat beauty queen made of stardust. The two of them have to work together if they hope to rock their small town by winning the annual Miss Meteor pageant. N is for Watch Over Me by Nina LaCour. It's a contemporary ghost story about Myla, who's just aged out of the foster care system and been offered a place to stay in Northern California. But when she gets there, she realizes that the farm may be haunted by the trauma of its former residents. O is for Each of Us a Desert by Mark Oshiro. It's a Latinx high fantasy story about Xochitl, who has the ability to take people's stories into her body so she can release them back to the desert. She finds herself on the run with a tyrant's daughter, and the two of them flee into the desert in hopes of finally finding a safe place. P is for Pepper's Rules for Secret Sleuthing by Briana McDonald. It's a middle grade mystery about a young amateur sleuth named Pepper who's putting investigating on the back burner after her last case ruined any chance she could have had with the girl she likes. But she can't help but smell a mystery after her great aunt Florence passes away under very mysterious circumstances. Q is for the aforementioned Boy Queen by George Lester. It's about Robin who's scrambling to figure out what he should do with his life after being rejected by drama schools all over the country. So when he and his friends go to drown their sorrows at a local drag show, Robin realizes that maybe he's destined for a different kind of performance. R is for The Boy in the Red Dress by Kristen Lambert. It's a YA historical mystery set in 1929 New Orleans. Millie is running her aunt's speakeasy when a young socialite is found dead. The officials suspect the club's star drag performer Marion after uncovering some damning evidence. So it's up to Millie to clear her friend's name and demand justice. S is for Spell Hacker by M.K. England. It's about a form of magic known as Maz that used to be a natural resource. Now it's become highly commodified, which is why Diz and her friends run a highly lucrative, highly illegal Maz siphoning business. Everything changes when they accidentally discover a new and highly dangerous form of Maz. T is for The House in the Cerulean Sea by T.J. Clune. It's a contemporary fantasy about Linus, a perfectly ordinary caseworker for the department in charge of magical youth who's assigned to investigate the Marseilles Island Orphanage, which is home to 6 children who possess extraordinarily powerful and dangerous magic. U is for Check Please, Sticks and Scones by Ngozi Ukazu. It's a comic following vlogger, amateur baker extraordinaire, and former figure skater Eric Biddle as he goes to college and trades his ice skates for hockey skates. V is for Beyond the Gender Binary by Alok Vaid Menon. This is a short collection of essays challenging trans myths and exploring trans experiences as told by Alok, who is an extraordinary writer, performance artist, and activist. W is for The Summer of Everything by Julian Winters. It's a contemporary romance about Wes, who works at a local indie bookstore and pines over his best friend Nico. When the bookstore is threatened by a coffee franchise, Wes will have to see if he has what it takes to save the store and finally win over his crush in the process. X is for Phoenix Extravagant by Yoon-Ha Lee. It's an SFF story about a non-binary artist named Yenjebi who's a known pacifist. When they're denied the chance to be a court artist, they find themselves drafted by the military to paint the glyphs that animate the government's automata soldiers and creatures. Y is for You Should See Me in a Crown by Leah Johnson. Liz Lighty dreams of studying music and medicine at a prestigious college, but when her much-needed scholarship falls through, she finds that turning to the scholarship her school offers the prom king and queen just might be her last chance. And finally, Z is for The 30 Names of Night by Zane Jogadar. 5 years after the mysterious fire that killed his mother, a closeted Syrian-American trans boy finds himself in search of a new name. When he discovers the journal of Layla Z, who documented and painted North American birds, he realizes that his mother may be connected to this artist. So there you have it. Those are 26 more queer books that fall somewhere in the alphabet and also 26 fantastic 2020 releases. There were so many more that I just couldn't fit, but let me know in the comments below which 2020 queer release you definitely would have picked. And obviously for me, come hell or high water, it was Cemetery Boys. But that's everything I had for this video today. Until next time, educate yourself, be kind to yourself, take care of yourself, and I will catch you on the flip side of the page.